Today I'm going to be showing you the best Blackmagic camera app settings for filming in Apple Log with the iPhone 15 Pro. So if you want the best possible video quality that will give you the most dynamic range and a file size that is much smaller than the stock camera app, keep watching. Also, because I'm all about saving you time, I've put together a set of video presets called Who is Matt Lutz. You can check them out down in the video description. And I have tested these with log footage filmed with the iPhone, and they look fantastic, and they work with the Blackmagic Camera app. They also work with pretty much any other camera that uses a log profile. So if you are wanting to get consistent, beautiful colors in your films, no matter whether you film with an iPhone or any other camera, you gotta check out these presets down in the video description. Jumping right into the Blackmagic Camera app now. You are first going to want to open up the settings menu, and for codec, you are going to want to set this to HEVC H.265. If you've watched my video about filming in Apple Log with the stock camera app, you will know that that app requires you to film using the ProRes 422 codec, which is going to give you high quality video, but with a massive file size. We're talking about 6 gigabytes per minute of footage recorded. Alternatively, by selecting HEVC H.265 in the Blackmagic Camera app, this is going to give you video quality that is basically 99% as good as that ProRes 422 in the stock camera app, but with about only 5% of the file size. As I just said, this is almost as good as ProRes 422, and the only time that I would select ProRes 422 in your Blackmagic Camera app settings is if you are filming someone in front of a green screen or in front of a solid colored wall, and you want to guarantee that you won't get any color banding, or if you have just tons of hard drive space and you don't care. But for literally any other situation, just select HEVC H.265 in the settings. It is going to look fantastic. Next, staying in the settings menu, for resolution, select 4K, and for color space, this is very important, select Apple Log, because this is going to give you the best possible quality from the iPhone by dramatically reducing the over-sharpening that the camera app usually adds, and giving you a much more pleasing image that will look fantastic once you color grade it. Did I mention you can do that with my presets? Anyways, I would leave all of the rest of these settings as they are and press the camera icon so we can dial in some more settings in the app. First, you're going to want to tap on WB, which stands for white balance, and lock this to an exact number. The number you choose is going to depend on your lighting, and if you're confused about white balance, don't worry, I have a whole video explaining what it is and how to set it on your camera properly. I will link to it in the corner and down in the video description. In this case, I'm going to set it to 5500. Next, tap the framing icon in the top right, and then tap on this zebras icon. If you don't know what zebras are, they are a fantastic way for you to be able to tell if your footage is overexposed or not. For Apple Log in particular, you are going to want to drag this slider until your zebras read 95%, which means that if you're seeing zebras in your preview, your footage is overexposed, and you're going to need to decrease the brightness of your image. This leads us into the rest of this tutorial, which is all about exposure. Because exposure with the iPhone 15 Pro in particular is a little unintuitive. But if you want to maximize your dynamic range and give yourself the best possible image, these are the settings that you need to use. The first thing I want you to notice is that if you tap anywhere on your screen, the Blackmagic Camera app is going to automatically adjust the exposure and focus of your image to expose for whatever you have tapped on. This is not ideal, because if you want to maximize the dynamic range of your footage, you need to set your ISO to approximately 1250. If you're a little below that, around 1100, or if you're a little above that, up to about 1450 or so, that's fine. Let me explain why you want your ISO to be in this range, but first I want to give a huge shout out and thank you to Gerald Undone and Patrick Tommaso, because they tested the dynamic range of the iPhone 15 Pro and discovered that at lower ISOs, Apple is artificially lowering the dynamic range of the image to reduce noise. What they also discovered, though, is that if you increase the ISO until it is in this 1100 to 1450 range, the dynamic range of the camera will no longer be limited, and your footage is going to look its best with the maximum possible dynamic range of approximately 14 stops, which is actually pretty competitive with many other cameras that are not just cell phones. So that's cool. So with this rough target of 1250-ish ISO in mind, we need to turn our attention back to the Blackmagic Camera app, because we run into that pesky issue of anytime you tap on the screen, it is going to not only adjust your focus, but also the exposure of your image. So even if you tap on ISO and change it to approximately 1250, anytime you tap on the screen to adjust your focus, it's going to adjust your ISO and exposure. To make things worse, you cannot lock the ISO like you can some of the other settings. So how do you get around this? To fix this, I want you to first notice that you cannot change your f-stop. The iPhone's cameras have a fixed lens aperture, so you cannot stop them down. You are stuck with the main camera lens being f1.8. Thankfully, you can adjust the shutter speed of your image, and you can crank it all the way up to 1/8,000th of a second if you need to, and more importantly, you can lock your shutter speed. And then here's where the magic happens. When you lock your shutter speed and you tap anywhere on the screen, suddenly the icon that appears whenever you tap only says AF, not AF/AE. AF stands for autofocus and AE stands for automatic exposure. And thankfully, because you have locked your shutter speed, tapping on where you want to focus is not going to change your exposure anymore, which means that your ISO is going to stay locked to whatever ISO you set it to. So my recommendation to you is that if you are filming at 24 frames per second, set your shutter speed to 1/48th of a second, which is the Hollywood standard for motion blur at 24 FPS, and then change your ISO to 1250. This is going to give you the maximum dynamic range that your iPhone 15 Pro is able to record. Alternatively, though, if you want to film at a higher frame rate like 4K 60, which you can do with the Blackmagic Camera app without needing to plug in an external SSD, you can set your shutter speed even higher, as high as you need to go to properly expose your image. That leads us into the last hurdle that you're going to face if you want the maximum dynamic range when using this app, and that is that you are going to run into situations where your footage is too bright, especially if you're filming at 24 frames per second outdoors on a sunny day with your shutter speed locked to 1/48th of a second and your ISO set to 1250. That is just asking for an overexposed image. So that is where you're going to want to look into investing in an ND filter for your iPhone. I realize that you may be thinking, Matt, this is a phone I carry around in my pocket. I don't want to have to rig it out a ton. And to that, I would say that's totally fine. In your case, you may want to use the stock camera app and watch my other video that explains how that will still give you great quality. But if you want the absolute best quality, which I'm trying to give you in this video, an ND filter is what you need. You have a ton of options out there. There are companies that make cases that will let you mount an ND filter directly to the case, or you can buy a clip-on adapter that will let you mount an ND filter. It doesn't matter. What matters is that you get a variable ND filter of some sort in front of your lens, because with all these other settings dialed in, it is going to be one of the best ways for you to properly control your exposure. Don't worry, I will link to some cases and ND filters down below for you. And once you do that, your footage is going to look great with the best dynamic range, highest quality, and smallest file size. I think you're going to be really happy with the footage that you're getting from your iPhone 15 Pro. Speaking of things that you'll be happy with, if you have not checked them out yet, I would highly recommend checking out my color presets that work great with the iPhone 15 Pro as well as any other camera that you may have. No matter whether you film in a log picture profile or not, I will link to these presets down below. Also down below, I'll throw a link to my edit videos like a pro guide. This guide is completely free and will walk you through some of the biggest things that took me years to learn as a video editor, and I think it's going to be super helpful to you. You can download it at the link down below. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.